सो एज आई टोल्ड यू, गैन्स आर द जनरेटिव मॉडल्स यूज फॉर अ सुपर अनसुपरवाइज लर्निंग प्रपोज्ड बाय इयान गुडफेलो इन 2014. सो इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ द टू नेटवर्क्स, अ जनरेटर एंड अ डिस्क्रिमिनेटर. जनरेटर वर्क इज टू जनरेट न्यू एडवर्सरियल इमेजेस. डिस्क्रिमिनेटर इज टू डिस्क्रिमिनेट वेदर द इमेज इज रियल और इट इज फेक. ओके, सो व्हाट आई मीन बाय फेक, इफ इफ द इमेज इज जनरेटेड यूजिंग अ जनरेटर देन इट इज गोइंग टू बी लेवल लेस फेक फॉर द डिस्क्रिमिनेटर. ओके, सो बोथ द नेटवर्क कंप्लीट्स अगेंस्ट ईच अदर एंड we get our generator trained. We will see all those things. Okay, so now let's see the probability distribution. So these are the images we sample from the real world distribution, and when we encode these images in a 2D dimension space, we have this kind of representation. So this is a probability distribution of all those images. And suppose, wait a second. And suppose we have taken some of the images from generated distribution. Okay, so these are the images from the stack GANs. Okay, and we plot its probability in a 2D map, and we will find such kind of probability distribution. So our basic job is to match the distribution of the generator with a real data distribution. So that is our goal. So if we can do it, if we get the real world distribution probability like a real world distribution, then we can say yes, your generator has a good ability to generate new images. So basically, this is a generator network, and you give a noise. As I told you, you need to give a noise to the generator, and it generate some kind of random images because initially it is not trained. So we get some kind of random noise here. Okay, so now we want some real images now, but we get some different noise because it is not trained. So we need to train it. So how we are going to train from the true data distribution? So that is the thing. So now we are moving forward in a training procedure of the GANs. So first I will let you know that GANs are very hard to train. Often I simplified it. The way to train it, I will explain it from the scratch. Okay, so this is the generator network. Okay, you give a noise, and initially generator gives you a random noise. Okay, so now you want it to train. So what we will do, we will have some real images, real data set, and we will have a discriminator. So we will give the real images and the generated images to the discriminator, and our discriminator will classify by equal to 0 if it is comes from generator, and by equal to 1 if it is coming from discriminator. So all the images under the real data distribution will be labeled as 1 because they are real, and all the images the generator will generate will be labeled as 0. Okay, so now how the training procedure works. So we calculate the loss and all loss, and we calculate the gradient, and then what we will do, we will backward propagate the gradient all the way back to the generator network. So suppose if your generator generate this kind of images, and it said and you give it to a discriminator, and the discriminator said yes, it is by equal to 0, means it's a generated image, the discriminator is able to classify. So we will back propagate all the gradients to the generator, and generator will try hard to generate a kind of images so that discriminator can be fooled. So this optimization process works, and at the end we get this the images to be a real when our discriminator will not able to classify whether the image is from generator indiscriminator. So what will be a condition when discriminator will not able to distinguish whether the generator, whether it's a generated image or a real image. So when it is, when it will give you the probability of 0.5 or something like that. So you will say, yes, that discriminator is not able to distinguish whether it's a generated image and the real image. So that is how the training goes on. Okay. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Because we are moving to a mathematical explanation for the same. And this is the optimization process. The way we backpropagate the gradient all the way back to the generator, and generator will then modify the pixel in our image, and the generated image will then again fed up into a discriminator. The thing is, discriminator is also important, guys. If your discriminator is not good, if it is not good in classifying the generated image or real image, then you can't able to learn. We will see it also. Okay. So now, I guess no one has any doubt. So we will move forward a training procedure. How we can train against. So what will be a cost of the discriminator, guys? You can tell me this, because you use the CNN network. So what is the loss function you use in a basic CNN network? Type no if you can't able to remember it. Like obviously you guys have created some of the CNN network also, and you uses a cost function, and that cost function has a name. So I'm just asking you the name. Yes. So we got the answer. We are using the cross entropy. So since we are working on a binary classification, we will use a binary cross entropy loss. And this is how the cost function of the discriminator looks like. Okay. So there is a slight difference from the regular binary cross entropy, that since all the images from the real distribution is labeled as one, so we do not have any fake images in a real data set. So basically, this term is saying that these should correctly label real data as one. Okay. And here, apart from using on a real data set, we are using it on a generated data set. And this term is saying that these should correctly label generated image as zero, because what we want discriminator to classify whether the image is generated or real. So that is the cost of the discriminator. Okay. So now see the cost function of the generator. Would you like to guess what could be a cost of the discriminator? Take some random guess. It is related to the cost of discriminator, because what we want what our discriminator is doing. We just want the opposite the discriminator is doing. So if discriminator is classifying the generated image as zero, what we want the same generated image to be labeled as one. It is cross entropy. Yeah, you can say it. It's a bit complicated. So it's basically a cross entropy loss. Obviously this loss we are going to use, but here what we have, since we are not going to pass any real images in a generator, we are working on a generated image. So y real will be zero in this case for the generator. Okay. And we will left with this only, this term. So you can see, but the thing is, since it is this term is used full zero when the label is generated, so what we will do, we just put a negative sign here. Okay. So by using a negative sign, what we are doing, we are now doing the opposite case. So here G is trying to fool the D, and I hope you guys got the intuition here. What we are doing, these classifying the generated data as zero, but here we want the opposite thing. So we want that schemata to classify it as a one. So that's a loss function we are going to use. Just opposite of the schemata, because we want the opposite thing to happen. Okay. So now this is the one type of way we can train the network, but often this is often we see that this loss function doesn't work good. Okay, because okay, I will we will see it in this graph. So suppose this is the discriminator output of your generated images. So initially, discriminator, if it's a fake image, discriminator will say it's give zero, and if it is a if the discriminator get fooled, then it will say it's a one. Okay. Then often this is a saturating cost. Okay, so here you can see in this region we have very small gradients. Okay, so it will initially our generator is also not good in generating that data set, so we will be somewhere here. And in this region, we are seeing that the gradients, I'm talking about the saturating cost, which we have talked about earlier in our previous slide. Okay. So in this region, you can see the gradient are very small. And if you have a very small gradient, you cannot train effectively. So what we have done, we created a non-saturating cost for the same. What we have did, we just did a mathematical transformation for the same. So we need to minimize this thing. Okay, what we have done, we have this is a mathematical thing. You need to if you are minimizing it, then it is same as maximizing log of d of g of z. G of z is an image generated by the generator, and we are feeding it to a discriminator. Okay, and then if you are using the minus sign, then you will use the minimum. Okay, so your max will convert it into a minimum because we use a negative sign. So this is how a graph looks like. And here you can see at the initial reason we do have some gradients. It is not zero, just like in this case we have a small gradient, but here we do have the gradient, and that's why we use this kind of loss that is called as a non-saturating cost. And it is more effective as compared to the saturating cost if we are going to train the GANs. So these are two methods I have discussed. One, you can use the saturating cost for training the GANs, and another method is non-saturating cost. Okay. So what do you think? Which network is difficult to train? Generator or discriminator? Type something in the chat box. Generator. Anybody is here who is thinking that it is tough to train the discriminator as compared to generator? You can type yes and no. Okay, so although we got our answer, the answer is generator. Obviously, if I give you an image and say classify tell whether the image is cat and dog, then you can say it in a second. Yes, it's a cat. But if I give you a blank paper and ask you to draw an image, then it's a very tough task. And the same is applied to the generative adversarial network. So generator is very tough to train as compared to discriminator. So now question is, which one is most important to train the GANs? Discriminator and generator. Option will be same. Think guys, which one is most important network to train the GANs, whether it's a discriminator or a generator? Okay, we got one answer, discriminator. Okay, let not waste much time. Okay, so the answer is obviously the discriminator, because if your discriminator is not able to distinguish whether the image is real or generated, then how will you train your generator? Okay, so discriminator is most important. And the thing is, you cannot have a very good discriminator at the starting. What you need to do, you need to simultaneously train the network, guys. That's how both the network, that how you can progressively train the GANs. So this is the most important thing. Okay, so as I already told you, discriminator is more important, because if you cannot able to distinguish whether it's a real image or the fake image, then there's no any way you can train the generator. Okay, so what we will do, this is another hack for the problem. So what we can use for the number of epochs, we use the k iteration for training the d, and only one iteration for training the generator. So this is how our discriminator will be better. Okay, and this is how we can progressively train the network. Okay, so let's talk about different type of gain: MM gain, NS gain, W gain, min max gain. So we have talked about these two initial, the min max gain, and we use this kind of loss function here. And for the generator loss, we use a saturating cost. So and for the for this gain, we are non-saturating gains, we use this log of dx. Here we are using log of 1 minus dx, and these both are same. And we can have another type of gain which are using different types of loss function in order to improve the result. You can check this paper. It is one of the best paper we do have for the comparisons of the gains, that are gains created equal a large scale study for the same. Okay, so here you can see the explosive growth in gains in 2014. Jans Goodfellow give one research paper, and in the recent year, in 2015, 16, 17, 18, we have an explosive growth that is called as exponential growth. Okay, one research paper give birth to hundreds of research papers, and it is also one of the hottest research topic nowadays as well. And since I have a data of up to 2018, there's many more research publications in 2019, 2020, and 2021, and researchers are trying hard to train GANs more better and efficiently, and many more things, and to make GANs to put in our industrial uses. Okay, so I'm moving